Hello, in this video I'll demonstrate how to properly prepare and cleave a fiber using an FBC007 high performance cleaver on a 250 micron fiber in a buffer tube fanout kit. Corning Cable Systems always recommends using a buffer tube fanout kit for 250 micron fiber termination in order to provide adequate protection for the fiber. If you have any questions about how to properly install a buffer tube fanout kit, please check out our videos on this topic first. Be sure to closely follow all recommended safety procedures when working with these tools and fiber optic products. Always wear safety glasses. Prior to preparing the fiber, please ensure that the high-performance Unicam tool is properly loaded with the correct connector. This will enable installation of the fiber into the connector after cleaving, reducing the chance of contaminating the fiber prior to termination. First, we need to ensure that the buffer tube fanout kit fiber track is properly installed in the FBC007 cleaver. What we'll do is press the black latch located to the right of the red button, open the cleaver up, remove the 900 micron handler, and slide the fiber guide in. On the bottom, you'll see that there are two catch rails. They're going to slide into the grooves located on the FBC007 cleaver. What we're now going to do is insert the guide into the cleaver, let the catch rails go into the grooves, and you'll see on the front you'll reach a positive stop as you hit the fiber guide. The guide does not have a magnetic catch, but if you look in here you'll see that there is a little catch that sticks up. That will actually catch on the lid of the cleaver as you close it and hold it in place. So let's close the cleaver, you should hear a click, and as you can see it's now firmly in place. For ST and ST compatible connectors, slide on the appropriate boot. As you can see here, we have the 900 micron type buffered boot. It comes in the Z-pack and it also comes in the single packs. For LC connectors, remember to slide on the back trigger guard next after you put the boot on. Using the strip length gauge, measure out 44 millimeters of 250 micron fiber. Next, we need to place a 4 millimeter mark, 4 millimeters from the end of the buffer tube fanout kit on the 250 micron fiber. If your kit has a double-sided handler, you need to place the mark at 42.5 millimeters instead of 44 millimeters. Next, if you're still using a double-sided handler, make sure to place the mark at 2.5 millimeters past the end point of the buffer tube fanout kit. For ST and SC compatible connectors, you need to measure and mark 11 millimeters of the buffer tube fanout kit. This is our final mark. The mark we just made serves as a visual aid to indicate when the field fiber connects with the fiber stub inside the Unicam tool. For LC connectors, that visual mark we just placed needs to be 9 millimeters instead of 11. You'll now need your dual hole fiber stripping tool. As the name implies, this has two grooves in order to strip fiber. The larger groove does 900 micron, the smaller groove strips 250 micron coating off. We're now going to strip off the 250 micron acrylate coating using the smaller hole on our dual stripping tool. Insert the fiber into the hole and at the 4 millimeter mark, or 2.5 millimeters depending on which handler you have, strip off the coating. Next, we'll grab a fiber wipe, dampen it with some fiber cleaning fluid, and we'll clean off our bare fiber. Take the dry portion and then dry it off. Be careful not to erase the visual marks located on the buffer tube fanout kit. Next, we're going to insert the fiber into our blue buffer tube fanout kit handler. We're going to open up the lid. As you can see, there's a magnetic clasp that holds the lid closed. You'll see a larger groove and a smaller groove. The 900 micron coating goes into the larger groove. The 250 micron coating goes into the smaller groove. Just insert the fiber. And as you can see right here, there's a positive stop that prevents overfeeding that 900 micron buffer tube. We'll now close the lid. You should feel the magnetic clasp catch. If using the double-sided handler, the process is exactly the same. So we want to make sure that the words fan are facing upward. We're going to open the silver door. We're going to place the buffer tube in the handler. And we're going to line the end of the buffer tube up with the machined silver line. Close the silver door and you'll feel a magnetic catch close and hold the fiber in place. Picking up our tool in our left hand, press both the black and red buttons and slide the fiber down the handler into the cleaver. You'll feel a magnetic catch grasp that handler as you get into place. Release both the red and black buttons. Cycle the red button once to ensure the fiber is properly in the fiber groove. Let go. Press the blue button. That's just cleared the fiber. Next, press in the black button, remove the fiber handler, and your fiber is now cleaved to the correct 10 millimeter cleave length. Open up the clasp, remove the fiber, and the fiber is now ready for termination. The final step is to remove the fiber scrap from the cleaver. Grab a hold of the fiber scrap, press the red button, and remove the fiber. Please dispose of it in a safe manner. I recommend a tape roll. That's it. If you have any questions or recommendations for videos, call us or send us an email at cablesystems@corning.com. Remember, Corning Cable Systems recommends getting trained in fiber optic installation. We offer a series of classes. Thank you.